What's good, everybody? My name is Christic, and welcome back to Fran Bow. I don't remember where we quite left. Oh, this is where we quite left off. I was the cat. After Fran took one of Fran's shoes. I don't think that was his voice. These are Fran's stockings. Fran's shoe. Uh-oh. Whoa! What an ugly tree. I scratch you, evil thing. Kitty? Kitty, stop it. What are you talking about? Fran? My darling, is that you? It can't be. What is it, my dear? Of course it's me. Who else would I be? Fran, you are a tree. Don't be silly. Help me up. Few questions here. Wait, just a second. Where are my hands? I can't move. I'm telling you, my dear, you have become a tree. What? But how? Oh dear, this was the end of the line. The big monster did this. I know it, Kitty. He won't let us go home. I hope he won't come back. He was very scary. He always comes back. I think I remember him from that night. The night Mom and Dad died.
Oh wait, that's her. Oops.
Kitty, I don't want to talk about it. I just want to go home. But you're a tree, my friend. A tree. I can't carry you all the way back home. Besides, I'm not sure where we are either.
Am I gonna die, Kitty? Tell me.
Please don't say that, Fran. Don't leave me.
But I feel so weak.
Because that's normal. Humka igne mehula. Korke irgranma. Pas guhula ne. Igne joklen vante.
You are a bunch of vegetables.
Be careful, sir. Where are you attacking me? Could you please tell me where I am, sir?
Hula korke hala.
Stop it, I'll scratch you.
Hula romna igne.
What are they saying? Oh, my kitty, why is this happening to us?
Hula.
Stop attacking me, please. I mean you no harm. Kitty, help me find my purse, please. Maybe I can do something about this.
I'll see what I can do, Fran.
Can I attack him? Yeah, okay. You just... Okay. Oh, there it is. I see my friend's purse. Alright, well, let's go out. Alright, let's take one of them. Jam that in there. And there. Ta-da! I'm a smart kitty. Alright, let's get back to Fran. Here's the book with Fran.
My friend, my darling, I got the purse.
That's amazing. You're the best, Mr. Midnight. Now show the sir who is attacking me my family picture. Maybe he'll understand what a human is. Okay, I don't think he will.
Ah, throw my piece of...
Okay, where are you taking me?
They want to help you, Fran. I can feel it. Don't be afraid, my friend.
Kitty, stop them, please. Don't leave me. I will be right here with you.
Okay, we're just gonna, you know, leave her clothes and everything there. All right.
Chapter 3, Vegetative State.
Oh, okay, hello. Oh, they planted me!
Itmin bal mem, men not cast beer zil near hula undum.
Okay. There's more squiggly squeak.
Welcome, creature.
Oh, welcome, creature. My name is Zar. Do you speak human?
Oh my goodness, yes, finally, words I understand.
My good friend Ryan told me that you showed him an illustration with four humans and a cat. I assume you are one of them, the little girl. Please forgive my friend if he scared you. We have never seen a human looking like a tree before.
Let me explain.
Ho 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 ho, no need to speak, my child. The seed will show me everything.
Yes. Your face.
That's different.
Let's see. You are good, no doubt about that. A seeker of the truth. Very common of the bull family tree. Ah, your name is Fran. You are the girl with the passion for life. I see great love towards this little creature standing next to you. A cat, protector of gates. Interesting.
You can see all that?
Be quiet. I see something else. The seed doesn't hide anything. I see a world nobody should see. Nobody except for one.
What do you mean by except for one? You mean the monsters?
You're not supposed to be here, Fran. Poof, the seed is gone. That is the only thing I can tell you, my child.
Can you help me?
We can't let you leave now. It's too dangerous for us. You should never have been aware of our existence.
There must be a way. Am I dead or something?
Dead? Why would you mean by that?
You know, when you no longer exist? Besides, it's not normal to be a tree. I must be dead.
Death is nothing more than the absence of love. Once you can't feel love, you die. Even with your body still walks.
Then I'm not dead. You have to help me get back home.
Little cat, come closer. Let me see you. What is your name?
My name is Mr. Midnight.
That is indeed a very pretty name. Do you think Fran should go back home?
Yes, I do, sir. Show us the way back home. I implore you. I have a question. Are you the king?
Ha! You are hilarious. Yes, I am the king of Earth, Thirstar.
Oh, what an honor, your highness. By the way, I like your leaves. They are pretty.
King, sir, please, will you help me?
Why is this need of you going home so great? The seed told me your story. You don't have much to go back to.
There are many reasons, sir. But the most important is my aunt. She will protect me. I want to feel that somebody cares about me. I feel confused almost all the time, and I want to be someplace where I feel at home, sir.
I see. You are very brave.
I just want to go home. Please help me.
There are things I cannot do, but I will help you. I will lead you to the door that will take you home, but it is your own task to walk through it.
Really? Oh, thank you so much. And where is this door, sir?
We'll talk about that later. First things first, you must be able to walk and... to talk and walk on this land.
Yes, sir. That would be very great.
I'm afraid I won't be able to bring your human body back. Only the great wizard can do it. But we'll talk more about him after the procedure. You must first understand our language.
But how will I ever understand your language?
Eat this fruit. Here you go. Your ears and tongue will be able to understand, but not your eyes. That means you won't be able to read.
Don't worry about that. I can always ask. Excuse
me. Do you understand what I say, human lady?
Yes, I do, and you sound kind. This is incredible. Did you understand my kitty?
I didn't, Your Highness. I demand one fruit for myself.
You don't need the fruit, Mr. Midnight. Our land is based on fragrances and sound. You'll see everything as your own world very soon. No doubt about that.
He'll do fine, kitty. And sir, do you know why I became a tree?
Yes, but I don't think I'm the right one to give you the answers. Now it's time for the procedure. Are you afraid of heights?
It depends on the height. Why?
Take her upstairs immediately.
Oh, you're a monster.
Where are you taking me? What are you going to do to me?
To get some arms and legs. Everything will be fine.
I'll be waiting for you, Fran. I love you.
Okay. Oh. What are you? You're like a Zoltal.
Good day. My name is Palantras, and I'm your doctor today, at your humble service. And you are the emergency case.
Whoa, amazing. What a huge, beautiful, fluffy thing.
Excuse me? Oh,
I'm sorry. It's just that I've never seen anything like you before. I'm still trying to understand that all of this is real. My name is Fran. I am a human girl. The king sent me here to get some arms and legs so I can go home.
Oh, a human. I think we can get you a pair of arms and legs. But we'll have to travel a little bit further in order to fix that. Are you ready to enter the paws of the beast?
What beast?
Me, I'm the beast. Let's go.
A flying Zoltal.
Okie dokie.
Here we are.
Wow, this place is so beautiful and peaceful. I wish I could be here forever.
Thank you. This is my home. This is where I was born. The spirit of the great Vulcas created it. It has the purest waters in the whole universe.
Oh, wow. That sounds amazing. When do we start?
Oh, right. We wait until the water purifies the curse. In the meantime, we can dock.
All right, so is this Vulcas.
Haven't you heard about the five realities?
I have a feeling we're about to.
He is the king of the first reality. A long time ago, he was at war with the darkness, and one day he fell. He fell so badly his heart was broken. He was all alone. But he came to...
Oh, God, is it Earthursta?
Earthursta, and his blood made this water pink. That is why it's so pure. It was very long time ago.
Wow, that sounds grand. I mean, I didn't know about the other realities.
And how is it that you are here? What brought you to Earthursta?
My kitty and I were on our way back home. I was so happy to see him and hug him again, but then we fell. The big monster that follows me did this. He broke the bridge. He wants me dead.
Would like to see you dead. That sounds terrible.
I prefer not to talk about this. But Sir Doctor, do you know why I became a tree?
Yes, sometimes our wishes are so strong that they become true. You did this in order to keep yourself alive. Think about it this way. Your human body was destroyed. But you wanted to keep being Fran. You wanted to keep your life. So you took on this empty shell to maintain all of your precious memories with you. It is actually the first time I've seen a human using a tree as a chrysalis. But it's dangerous to have you here. It makes our land vulnerable.
I did this to myself? Wow, but... Palantra, sir. How? I didn't know I was doing anything.
You really didn't know what you were doing? I see. Well, when you traveled to Ithsta, you opened a door between your reality and ours. And with this door opened, an unexpected creature can also enter our reality. And if that happens, the balance will be tainted. And there's only one who would like to poison the second reality. The monster, the terrible black.
Oh,
I can't see this happening again. I just can't.
Don't be sad, Doctor. I'm very sorry for what I did. I didn't mean to.
Oh, little girl, you're so nice. You don't have anything to be sorry for. I think you're very special, but let's concentrate on your arms and legs, all right?
Yes, Doctor.
Soldier of the Sun, Spirit of the Water, give Fran her arms and legs.
Well, that's better.
How do you feel, Fran from Earthstar?
Wow, I feel... like a beautiful tree. I have leaves.
I'm glad you like it. I told you we would fix it. This water is magical. It can fix anything.
Anything?
Do you think it could...
Oh, do you think it could fix my mommy and daddy?
What do you mean, fix them? What's wrong with them?
Nothing, Doctor. Thank you very much for helping me. You're the best doctor I've had, and you are fluffy and beautiful. I had another doctor before. His name was Dr. Dern, but he was an evil old man.
An old man? I bet he wasn't that bad. Maybe he was just following the rules. Let's go now. I'll leave you at the station.
Oh, she's a tree person now. And off they go.
Here we are again, Shazar the King. What a nice
Etherstanized
you've become.
Thank you again, Doctor. You have to meet my kitty someday.
That would be lovely. I would see you soon.
Goodbye. Oh, and off he goes.
Can I fall off? No, I can't. Okay.
You fluffy kitty. Ah, do you like that?
Here I am.
Fran, my dear, you've got leaves on your head. How pretty.
Oh, let me see you. What a great earthen knight you've become.
Thank you, King Sir. The doctor is incredible. He made magic with the water. But he was sad. He told me many things, but I didn't quite understand.
Don't worry. Palantras will be fine. I know the reasons. We have some problems to solve, but that's nothing you should worry about. Let's talk about how you can get back home, right?
Yes, please. You said something about a great wizard.
Yes, the great wizard is the only one who is able to bring your human body back. And he has the stones that can open the door that will lead you home.
Where is the wizard? What stones? This land is full of things I just don't understand.
Ha! You haven't even gone outside this castle and you already want to know everything? That's the passion I was talking about. Have patience, Fran. The great wizard lives in the great mountain Cotterum, but we haven't seen him for a while now. Find him, and everything will be just fine.
Why haven't you tried to find the great wizard yourself?
Well, we don't need to. It's very logical. You'll see, we don't need a wizard to perform magic or prepare potions. We can do that ourselves. The wizard's most valuable task is to protect the stones that open the door.
I see, so the stones are like keys. And where is this mountain, you said?
You'll have to ask around. Follow the signs. I have to go now. But I'll be back in time to help you with the door. Have a great Ethesda day, you, and good luck finding the great wizard.
Oh, okay. Doodles. Wow. Did you see that huge creature kitty? That's Palantras. He fixed me.
Yes, it's certainly very fluffy. Oh, I forgot. Here's your purse.
Thank you, kitty. Did you see my pills anywhere?
I don't think so. Maybe they're on the other side of the lake, next to your clothes.
Well, we have other things to do anyways. We have to find the wizard.
Yes, the king said something about a mountain, too.
Yes, Mount Cortrum. The great wizard lives there. Let's go. Oh, kitty. You don't... Oh my god, the hand is a tree stump now. Oh, the flowers are huge. Alright, well, let's... Oh, Beetle Man! Yo, what up, boy?
No, no! You can't get in, it is closed!
I didn't know what's behind this passage.
Well, the library, of course, but it's closed. Come back and follow Winter, then it will be open. Hey! Aren't you the talking tree I took to see Palantras?
That's me, yeah.
Yes, and also a head. That's very positive.
Yeah, but why is the library closed, sir?
Well, that's logic. As the sun goes around, the second moon of Ursus that we open. Only then the real knowledge will be learned. And that's the only happens in the fall and winter.
Oh, okay. So you really won't learn anything?
Of course we learn. We learn all the time. I'm learning now. That you like to ask many questions.
I'm just curious. That's why everything looks so different in here.
I guess you're not from around here. Well, I hope to see you soon.
Yes, thank you, sir. Bye. Let's look out the window. Oh, I can see many clouds. Okay. Can I go this way? Wow, this is a bit scary, but so beautiful. Alright, well, let's go out. Well, that's a thing. Hello, sir. Are you a guard?
Yes.
Do you know where Mount Cortrum is?
Yes.
Where is it?
Yes.
Tell me, please.
The Mount Cortrum is only in winter time.
Winter time? Oh, what are you talking about?
Of course, winter time. What do you think?
I can't wait for winter.
Oh, you don't wait for it. You go there.
Go? What? How?
Sorry, but I'm no good at explaining things. Go down the stairs and then straight. You'll find a clockmaker. He can explain things, I think. He tried with me before.
Oh, okay. Thank you. Them just fluting about in the background. It's hilarious. Oh, it's so pretty. I wonder what kind of stones these are. Fish. Hello, fishy.
Alright, what's the sign say?
Okay, so that is the mountain. That's the king's, and that looks like a thing. So,
I think I might want to go this way.
Okay. Let's talk to the beetle.
Hello.
Ah, who is there? Who?
Can't you see me, Fran?
Oh, no, I see a little. You have four eyes. Wow.
What are you selling? What are you selling?
Only the very best plumas of this entire land. Do you want to smell it?
They look like coconuts.
It's poo, miss. Poo that I collect. They are not coconuts.
Poo? Like in toilet? Wow. I thought it was really bad to eat poo.
Bad? Why? It's very yummy. We love it. It makes everything grow and shine.
Okay, I gotta go. Have fun with your poop sticks. Hello, I'm Fran. What are you making?
Good day. I am Bruta, and I'm molding this piece of iron.
For what?
I have to deliver a few clock pieces to the clockmaker.
You make this kind of stuff?
Sure, I have some ideas. We can talk about them and... Parma, I do it.
That's very good to know. Thank you, sir.
Well, I have to keep working, but if you need my services, you know where I am.
Alright. That's the marketplace. Oh, okay, here's the clockmaker. Hello, what are you doing?
Working on my clock.
I'm looking for the wizard.
No, miss. I do clocks. I fix clocks. I listen to clocks. Tick-tock.
Do you know where Mount Cotrum is?
The Mount Cotrum only exists in wintertime. Otherwise, it's just a regular mountain.
Well, I can't wait for winter. The king said that the wizard should be in the mountains.
You don't need to wait for winter to come. That's absurd. Time is an infinitely layered reality.
Okay, what should I do?
Go to the big clock and change the season. Just change it.
Okay, where is it then, Smarty Pants?
Well, go towards the castle, but turn to your left when you see the stairs. You'll find a big clock on a tree. Good luck.
Thank you, sir. You're very nice. Bye. What's this? Oh, to carry heavy things. Okay. Let's talk to you. Good day, sir.
Good day, little creature.
Flying, I see your flying boat, sir. How does that work?
Think about them floating on water. But instead of water, it's air. It's so simple.
Could I borrow one?
Oh, go home? I see. Sadly, these boats only work within Earthistanese.
I see. Well, thank you, sir. Have fun making your boats. Chanel?
Hello.
Good day, young one.
What are you doing?
The war is about to start, and I can't see meaning in meaninglessness.
What do you mean?
Join me, young one. You'll be rewarded with one gold coin if you come back alive.
Join you? Join you where?
The game is about to begin. We are the Camalas. I am the Vulcas. Black and white as shadows and light.
It's a board game?
Yes, a board game. Let's immerse in this adventure. You against me.
I give you a coin if you win, eh? What do you say? Oh,
I'll give you a coin if you say.
Okay, what are the rules?
First to place three of the same figures in a diagonal, horizontal, or vertical line wins. We toss the machinery and see who begins. Are you in?
So it's tic-tac-toe.
Time is gold, and I'm very old. I've been around a long time.
I'm sure you have.
I just want to have a good time.
I see. Well, let's play. Okay, so this is me. We're gonna go here. Okay. Here. 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 And here. Okay. my turn. Oh, he got me. But I got him. Bam! Gold coin! Oh, how many gold coins can I get? Yep, he got me this time. That's probably, oh, God. All right, we'll go there. And then we'll go here. He'll block me there, and then I'll go here. He'll block me there, and then I'll block him here. Wow, he's pretty good at tic-tac-toe, holy crap. Now I gotta be careful with how he plays. Yeah, like that, see? And then he'll get me right here. Okay. Oh, shit, he got me. Alright, we'll do one more. I got him both ways, and bam. Wonder how many gold coins I can get. Okay, that's enough. Very well done, little creature, you are master. Thank you. Let me check my purse here. Oh, you only get one? Oh, I have two gold coins. Okay. Oh, alright. This way, I guess? I think he said. Yeah, there it is. Shifaroa, where are the numbers? Lever. It sounds like something is, like, something's broken. Okay. Can I? Oh, hello. Hello.
Good day, living creature. All good.
What are you doing?
I'm smelling this flower. Beautiful creation.
Waiting for someone?
I'm waiting for the lemons to grow. Do you like lemons?
They're too sour for me.
Lemonade is what I would do with the lemons for the customers of the bar, you know? And we put some other stuff inside, too, so we can fly.
Wow, that actually sounds pretty great.
Yeah, that is why I wait. You can't rush it. Hey, this bar opens in the fall. A very awesome dancer will perform. You should come hang out.
Maybe I will. It sounds like fun. Thank you. Goodbye. Is that the lemon tree? Aunt Grace had one at home. Okay, so that's the bar. Oh, wow. What are you? You look like fairies in my book.
The purest of feelings, the light of all material, we are Vulcas.
Oh, you're very shiny and you make me feel so happy, so very happy.
Look, creature. One of the young Valkas will receive the shield.
And words.
Soldier of the sun, creature from the soil, fruit from the sea. Let the universe illuminate you with the truth and be free.
Okay. Huh? Where are you all going?
We continue our paths to life. May freedom be with you, my friend.
Sir or miss, can you do magical things?
The universe is already doing magic all the time. You are full of magic yourself.
But I wish to know things, and it's odd. I feel like you would know everything.
We are the light. We are everything. What answers are you looking for?
I want to know who killed my parents, and why is that big monster hunting me?
The truth will come to those who seek. Your path towards the truth is immense. You are living in a world that turns its back to you. You are too fragile to face the truth just now, and too strong to let it go.
Oh, okay. Thank you for the fortune cookie.
Dear, don't be sad. We have to keep going.
Oh, yes, kitty, you're right. I'm gonna toggle these knuckles. I'm gonna toggle, do that, Whoa, what a huge Valkas. It's not real, though. Okay, so there's that. No. Maybe they're what a huge Valkas. I wonder what they use it for. It has four arms. Okay, so if I do that, and I do that. Okay, so those only go. Okay, so that comes down. That goes there. That'll go up. If I hit that, that'll go up. Am I supposed to? Okay, we're gonna come back to that. I don't know what that is. Let's go up. There's the Valkas. Just, you know, squid doodling about. Alright, what's in here? It's nothing here but trees and flowers. Okay, well, can I go up? I can. This mountaintop is right because it's at the top. You are correct. What would a talking mountain would sound like? I wouldn't know, Fran. I would not know. Okay, well, that did absolutely bupkis for me. Huh, I wonder where they'd borrow that boat. Wow, the lake's very clear. Okay, nothing there. I can't turn this because it sounds like something's busted on the inside. So, off to talk to the clockmaker.
Sir, I have a problem.
Yes, I don't have any.
The clock's broken, man.
A broken clock? That's a disgrace, Buckler.
You have to help me. Please fix it for me, I'm begging you.
I never fix a clock for nothing, otherwise my lifetime goes to waste.
What do you mean? And I notice this is also the king's voice, too.
I charge one big gold coin per clock. Time is gold, you know.
I have a golden coin. Ha ha!
Oh, yes, but you have to offer me the job first, all right? Do it, been very polite.
Would you fix me the clock in exchange for this piece of gold? I beg you, accept my offer.
Of course! That was an incredible job, Mama! Very passionate.
Great, let's go to the big clock and fix it then. Oh, you are a monstrosity. I don't like it. Just fix the clock and never show your eekness to me again. Do I have to talk to you?
You're right, the clock is
You're right, the clock is broken!
You can fix it, right? I mean, I am paying for it.
Of course, just a second!
Ooh! Don't say it like that. What is it?
It seems that somebody was playing a dirty game around this clock!
What do you mean?
I mean, somebody broke it! It's immoral, breaking a defenseless clock! Ah!
Why would somebody break it?
Calabas, winter, mountain, quorum, the stones, many reasons, miss!
Oh. What are you talking about? I don't understand.
Calamus, the evil darkness. They work for Rimmer, the terrible black. And Calamus are the only ones allowed into this land. The only evil we have around. It wouldn't surprise me. Rimmer wants the stones. But what I don't understand is, for what purpose? The stones are meaningless for him and his kingdom. And the stones are in wintertime.
Is Remora a giant black monster with a goat mask? A dead goat mask?
Yes, you know him!
Yeah, I think it's because of him I'm in this land. I'm a human, you know.
Oh, a human! Now I understand!
I also need the stones. They're my way back home. I hope it's not too late.
Ah! That is why you need to go into wintertime and go to Mount Gorum!
Yes, exactly. I have to talk to the Great Wizard and borrow the stones.
Well, it's fixed now. I'll give you something that will make it easier for you. Yeah.
Thanks. I love it.
It's a remote control for the clock. You'll be able to travel into all four seasons in just a quick turn. But it's just a prototype, so it might not work if you're too far away. And remember, time is an infinitely reality, so be careful.
I'll be careful, thank you very much. You're a very nice clockmaker guy for an ugly turnip rutabaga thing.
Please, call me Cogwind.
I'd rather not. All right, Mr. Cogwind, I'm Fran, by the way. See you soon, bye. Never again. Okay, so spring, summer, fall, winter, I'm assuming. All right, so let's see what's what here. Okay, so the boat's here. Oh, look, Kitty, get in the boat. We're going for a ride. Okay, I guess this is a thing now. Oh, the other side of the lake. I could probably get my clothes. Oh, Fran. This is where we were before. I fixed the bridge to get your purse.
Wow, Kitty. You're very clever. I hope to find my things.
Yep, your things.
Kitty, I can find my pills. Maybe the pills aren't here. Maybe they lost them. Well, they weren't doing me any good anyways. Maybe they'll appear someday. Let's just keep looking. Use on Fran. Fran.
I found myself hunting the truth, but finding the unexpected. I found what my senses couldn't show me. I found the truth that relays silently in the unknown. Leon Castillo.
Okay, well, that's lovely. Ooh, what's back here? Oh, that must be the cat. Oh, okay. Well, I have my clothes now. So let's get in the boat and scoot our boot over to the other side. Is she gonna say something about the island? Oh, wow, the island's very tiny. Yay. Okay, so this mechanic is almost like the pills. What was that? Oh, I heard that. Okay, so what's this? What is that? What's that sound? Okay, so let's do it. Okay, so he's picking them. Sir, can I take one of your lemons?
I'm sorry, lovely. These lemon resources are quite limited. I can't let you take any of them. I take all the lemons that are in the basket and carry. That means all the lemons from the tree.
Okay. Oh, that means the bar is open. Oh, he looks terrifying.
Good day, little miss. Can you show me a ticket, please?
How do I get one?
Oh, what? I as a citizen get a ticket, and why don't you have yours?
I'm not a citizen.
Not a citizen? That's new. Too new for me. Sorry, little lady. I can't let you in.
All right, sir, I understand, but what can I do then? I really would like to go inside.
I don't know. This never happened before.
Well, I guess I'll have to find my own way inside. Thanks, bye, Kay, see ya. Okay, so what would happen with... I still don't understand what I'm supposed to do with this. Alright, so it's closed here. He's here. Still here. Okay, so this is the fall area. No wonder. Ah! Oh! Who are you?
Oh, are you the great wizard, sir? I need your help. Sorry, sir, I'm Fran. I need your help. Is this the mountain quorum? Can you talk?
You have too many questions. That's good.
The king said you'd help.
What the king says we do?
I need to borrow the stones.
The stones are missing, and I don't remember where they are. Every time they seek, I hide. Every time I hide, I forget. So they can't be found.
Oh, I see. But maybe I can help you find them?
I just want to know the biggest answer of them all. How does the rabbit do it? I saw it once. A human did it. The rabbit came from an empty hat. How? This is the greatest question of all. Because it's not... Nothing exists, then nothing exists. But if the nothing exists, then there is no nothing. I wonder again how...
Ask the person who did it.
Oh, I have a visitor. Good day. What brings you to the great wizard? That means me, just so you know.
The king sent me.
The stones? Oh, it's been a long time since somebody came around asking for the stones. I made the most fantastic spell of all time so nobody could find them. You know, the black shadows, the Gallimas, they try to steal them all the time. So I have to be sure.
I need the stones.
The stones are hiding? I only remember the four riddles that are connected to the stones. Four riddles that would unlock my memory. Only when all four riddles are answered correctly, I will be able to tell you where to find items.
These items are the stones in the layered reality. Then, the only one who can bring them back is me.
Lost information? What?
Let me show you.
Oh, please do. This will be interesting. I don't want to see it anymore. Okay, pentagram. Well, not really a pentagram. It's more of like a star.
This is the star of Amethysta. Omkabe, the greatest guide of the sky. The greatest caretaker of this land.
Oh, where are the riddles?
I'll give you the four riddles written down in the language of everything. The answer is always one item. Place the items on the star of Amethysta on the respective symbols. And after that, I'll be able to tell you where the stones are.
Thank you very much, Sir Wizard. Oh, Sir Wizard, the king told me that you can make me human again.
Did he? I think that's true. I barely remember how to do it, though.
You don't remember? But I can't go home like a tree.
I understand, but I can't help you right now. I have to recover some of my knowledge. Perhaps we can try to make you human again after you find the first stone.
Oh, that would be incredible.
Yes, incredible and great. Just try to figure out the riddles and I guess everything will be fine.
Sir, do I need something special to become human?
Oh, I think the spell is very important if I remember correctly. So bring me your clothes, then we'll see how it goes.
Explain. Could you explain the riddles again? I forgot what to do.
Just place the correct answers in the correct spots on the star of Amethysta. When you complete that, I can explain more to you. Now the rabbit science is waiting for me.
Let's check this out. Okay. Riddle the first. I am cold as I am, but if you use me, I'll be burning hard. I'm shiny as the sun, but I'll never burn you. Perhaps a sour smile I'll get you. That's a lemon. Because I remember that from her asking. Flow, flow, cold-blooded sun. Let your body dance through the rising stream. Is that water? Light and hollow. I'm the freedom of birds and the pen of man. That would be a feather. I'm cold as I am, but if you use me, I'll be burning hard. Is that a rock, maybe? I have nothing. Yeah, I got nothing. What's up here? Okay, well, this is all interesting and everything, but I think I'm gonna leave this episode here. Very interesting things that are happening. I'm Fran the tree now. Fern the tree, if you will. And I am trying to find my way home, apparently, through means of this little bully-looking troll wizard guy. And, that's all I got for that right now. So, with that, I want to thank you guys so much for watching. If you liked it, let me know in the comments below. And as always, I will see you guys in the next video.